deficit disorder or your height challenge, you need someone to listen to 3 minute poems, probably your section.
This is called Ted Danson. My dream last night, Ted Danson walked past me and said, "Man, you are tall." And he tried to give me a high five. But when I woke up, I still couldn't reach the top of my can of peaches. Short poem.
When I'm drunk, I do an amazing Elvis Costello.
Elvis Costello doesn't do an amazing Elvis Costello.
No, that's a great point. This too soon. This short poem is called Quick Line for the Abstinent Lover. Baby girl. He looks so good. You look like a porno shop. And she said, "Oh, why? Because I'm fucking raw and sexy." I said, "No, because I could tell that I would be embarrassed to be inside you."
Oh.
The moon is the ocean's tramp stamp.
Triple.
Child, the first thing I would do upon entering someone's home is ask them where they kept the toys. If they said that they did not have any toys, I'd be like, "What the fuck?"
What are we doing here, buddy? What do you need?
Well, I just need some sweet backup music for this. I wrote a letter, and I think it would be nice. I know you got to get singing.
Oh, something a little rock and color?
Well, okay. Yeah.
You want some fucking metal?
Well, I don't know about metal. But
some vocal metal?
No, I wasn't thinking metal, actually. I was.
How about this jam? Mojo Razor. It keeps you regular. Mojo Razor. Your raisins are in my nightmare. Different song?
Please stop.
I think I know what you need, dude.
Okay, something smooth.
Yeah, fucking new Van Halen.
No, something.
That's what you're getting.
I appreciate it. Okay. Still going.
That's not the song?
That's not the song.
Something more...
Just make it, like, let's go smooth and manly.
Oh, smooth and manly, alright.
Something
like that. Something tough. Here we go.
Alright.
I tried to discover...
Oh, that's good.
A little something to make me sweet.
I'm homophobic, you guys good? Dear Proposition 8, Mormons, some of you, and Orange County, I officiated the wedding of a straight couple on Sunday, and I was thinking, I've been known to be pretty gay. Shouldn't this mean that their marriage not be recognized? Isn't the sanctity of a straight couple at risk if they're married by a gay dude? Shouldn't straight marriages performed by gay dudes be revoked as a safeguard against burning forever? Please help me help you help God help us. Or before you know it, they'll be letting murderers and animals officiate.
Oh.
Maybe even priests. Something more must be done to stop the spread of joy and butt sex. Looking to you for Christ-like moral guidance, because you and your divorce rates representing sanctity totally make sense to me. Sincerely, Reverend B. Wakefield.
Yeah. What moral reason would cause a man to forsake his lover? Don't you tell me no, don't you tell me no, don't you tell me no, don't you tell me no.
P.S. I feel like I should go after the Universal Life Church next, you know, to put an end to the possibility of openly human and or gay people presiding over straight weddings. Once that's accomplished, we can begin voiding the millions of marriages performed by such ambiguous clergy. It's a purification process, and should serve to bring the human race closer together. It may seem like de-evolution, or even Hitler-esque at first, but I, for one, understand that you have books to live by. Like, say, the Bible, which clearly states, all sins are measured equally. For instance, if I call you a retarded ape, that's a sin. Unless you're a retarded ape. At any rate, please stop. Abort your hateful mission. And do not teach your kids that shit.
So...